Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I'll show you an easy and efficient way of creating and editing your hyperlapse sequences inside Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2018. First, let's have a look at the following hyperlapse sequence that I've edited inside Premiere Pro, and then we will jump into the tutorial.
I have edited all the RAW CR2 files in Photoshop Camera Raw and exported all the images in JPG format inside a single folder. If you prefer Lightroom to edit your RAW images, then you can do the same thing with Lightroom as well. Just remember to save your images in proper sequence. I have already imported the folder inside Premiere Pro. This folder contains all the edited images in proper sequence. Now, click on this icon over here and create a new sequence. I'm going for a custom setting. The frame rate should be 23.976 and for the resolution, 1920 by 1080 is good for me. Now, click on the first image of your hyperlapse sequence and then scroll down to the last image in that sequence. And while holding down Shift, click on the last image to select all the images in the sequence. Now, drag all the images into your timeline. All your images should align properly one after the other. If you have messed up the naming of your files while saving from Photoshop or Lightroom, then you might have to check the order of the images and may also have to manually change it. All the images should have been placed with the default duration you have set for your images in Premiere Preferences. You may also notice that the images are way bigger than your canvas. To fit the images to the canvas, select all the images by pressing Ctrl plus A for Windows or Command plus A for Mac and right-click on an image and choose this option named Scale to frame size. We will fine-tune the scaling later on. Now once again select all the images and right-click on an image and click on speed duration. Here you need to change the duration for all the images to just one frame. Hit enter. Now all you need to do is to get rid of the blank spaces in between the images. To do that, just select all your images and go to sequence and then click on this close gap option. Your hyperlapse is almost ready. Now to polish it up, once again select all the images, right click on one of them and click on nest. Name the nested sequence to your liking and hit enter. Then go to your effects browser and search for warp stabilizer. Drag the effect to your nested sequence. Let it analyze the whole clip and once it's done, you should have a smooth hyperlapse sequence. Now you can treat this nested sequence as an individual video clip and you can add more effects to it just like you would have done to other video clips. You may need to manually adjust the scaling of the nested sequence to properly fit the canvas. You can also add a letterbox to give it a more cinematic feel. Moreover, you can also reposition the video for better framing or even keyframe some of the properties to add some fake movements.
So I hope you have found this workflow and the video helpful. If you have learned something new today, then don't forget to smack that like button, share the video, and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.